Hey, welcome to the crew too. I'm gonna take a drive. It's the 4th of July, so I feel like I'm gonna just take a drive. Right now the plan is just I'm driving up to Seattle, probably hit four corners of cities in the United States, but I don't mind people telling me where the hell I should drive. I'm gonna have to look it up somewhere else because this map ain't great. Think I can get a GPS going, and that'd be fine. I'm not exactly following the speed limit here, but I'm not exactly giving a shit either. I don't care about speed limits in video games, except for GTA 5. You should probably drive about what the speed limit says. Realistically, I probably should have got an off-road vehicle. Also, I should probably put like a map marker or something so that I know. Fame too low. I'm not trying to do shit. Isn't it a little early? Nah. I decided since it was the 4th of July, I wanted to start kind of early. I wanted to actually do something, and the only way for me to actually do something is for me to get on a little bit sooner. People are definitely going to be busy today. There we go. That's what I wanted. I wanted to actually have a waypoint to somewhere that I can drive. Well, I am. Sound better, like the audio sounds better. Well, I'm glad the audio sounds better. I've had some issues with putting the audio around. It's very hot, so fans and shit fuck with the audio. I need to get an air conditioner. I ain't got one working right now. I'm sure that Audi has an air conditioner. It looks too nice to not have one standard, but I am fucking it up. Maybe it won't have a working one by the end of the day. I was thinking I probably ought to go and visit places I actually know. I hadn't been to Los Angeles since I was like a child. It was kind of pointless being down here, though that's where it spawned me, rather than giving me any choice in where I actually start. I'd have to drive a couple places to go places I've actually been before, though. I was thinking, go to Seattle. I hadn't been to Seattle outside of the airport, and I hadn't been to Seattle in the airport since I was a baby. Crew 2 was on sale. It should still be on sale, at least on Steam. It was like 17, 18 bucks. It wasn't all that bad. I've been planning to get it for a long time. I was just hoping that there'd be a VR equivalent of driving around the United States in VR. That'd be really cool. And they flat out said at Ubisoft they are not going to put this on VR support. They're not doing that. That's way too much damn work. I understand. Oh, there's a thing I can get. I don't care enough. Driving around and not really playing the game. I wasn't really planning on playing the game. I haven't played this game. I haven't played this game at all, really. I just got it. I did the tutorial and now I'm playing it here. And I don't think that I'm playing it properly. I have surprisingly crashed into fewer things than I thought I would. I normally, when I play these kinds of games, I have to get used to it real heavy before I can actually avoid crashing. I've been crashing into a lot less. This looks like I'm way up higher north than I thought I would be. The forest up here looks like Oregon or Washington already. I thought I was still in Southern California. Really is a scaled down version of everything. Going to the bay. I am in Southern California. Oh, come on. Made me hit a damn thing. Yep, that is basically how everything works here. I don't care. I'm not trying to actually do a thing. Hey, objective completed. And then it probably took away my fucking map marker, so I'm driving up to Seattle, and I have no idea how to get there. Oh, thank you so much for the fucking money. I don't know who this guy is, but he is pointless. Oh, no. Okay. I was about to hit a deer with my car. Hitting deer with my truck was never a problem. I knocked a few of them over into the ditch, but hitting it with a fucking Audi, I doubt I'd survive that one. Well, it's kind of funny. I was driving around in Arizona yesterday. I got the game, checked it out. It was a clean turn. Hey, I'm not bad at this so far. I was driving around in Arizona trying to figure some controls out and stuff, and there was a dude walking on the sidewalk, and I tried to hit him because I wanted to see how the game would react to something like that. And it has some of the best scripting I've ever seen for people getting out of your way. I had to really, really try. Yeah, I nearly hit that bus, didn't I? I definitely scratched that fucking wall right there. I'm not supposed to be making these turns at 60, but I don't think that matters. I think that everything's scaled the way that it is. I'm probably fine. Probably, anyway. It's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the That's just programmed cars. That was NPCs in like a wreck. I didn't think something like that would... Oh, no, that's not an NPC. Never mind. They might be. Hell if I... Okay. Well, what if I was going to use that sign, assholes? I might have needed to know where I was going. These people are not very considerate of my needs. I'm still not even to San Francisco yet. I mean, I'm glad. Taking me a bit of time to get there. This Seattle trip's going to be longer than I thought it was going to be, which I'm sure is said by lots of people in L.A. Actually, in L.A., they know how long it's going to take. Crew 2, nobody gives a shit. Yeah, nobody cares. They're knocking down my signs. I was going to use that sign. You're very fancy driving. Try to avoid getting hit by those two. But they're in faster cars than me, so drive through town. Oh, wait a minute. This is a big hill. I'm probably in San Francisco or close by. I should probably stop by the Golden Gate Bridge. I ain't never been there before. It looks a lot like San Andreas, San Fierro, so I'm guessing this is, in fact, San Francisco. I came in through town and then didn't go towards... Yep, I'm in San Francisco. This place is too big not to be. Do not make me do that. Oh, come on, motherfucker. You made me look. All right. Just get to the speed. I got to the speed. There we go. Give me the thing. Now go away. I have to make a whole loop around and shit because I was in the wrong place. San Francisco is a dangerous place. Yeah, I missed my turn. See, that guy I hit. I had to try really hard to hit those people in Arizona. People in San Francisco just want to kill themselves. That must be what it is. That beeping is going to get real annoying, like Legend of Zelda annoying. That beeping is that you can gather a thing. Ooh, Golden Gate Bridge. I guess I just needed to come by here. I got a thing. Oh, shit. try to avoid other cars. That didn't work out, did it? Hit my NOS on the bridge. Just passing. I didn't realize that I was going that way. Oh, head-on collision. I started doing real bad once I got her out of San Francisco. Maybe that's a thing. Maybe that's the reason San Francisco and LA traffic sucks so bad. Everybody hates driving there, but something about the city just makes you bad at it. Nitrous oxide. It's nitrous oxide. It's NO2, not NOS, but people just call it NOS because 2 in leet is S. Hey, I got my teaching done for the day. I think I'm good. Oh shit, I forgot rain is a bad thing when you're driving fast. I hadn't driven fast in the rain most of my life. I'm very careful. I hydroplaned in my car once and did like, I think I did like a 540 or a 720 into oncoming traffic. And I was on a back road, so oncoming traffic was just a couple cars and they didn't hit me. They slowed down far enough away that I didn't have a problem. So, I usually don't drive fast in the rain because I know that I could probably die. You gotta be careful with that life-ending shit. I guess it makes sense that if I'm driving up towards Seattle, it would start raining somewhere outside of San Francisco. Northern California, it's always on fire or always wet. You gotta pick one or the other. Hear that phrase everywhere I've ever moved. Everywhere I've ever gone, they got the phrase, don't like the weather, wait 5 minutes. And everybody thinks it's unique to their area. But no, it's a pretty universal thing unless you're in a place like Death Valley. They got a set weather pattern and it stays that way. Northern California, like Middle California, you basically have the choice of rain or fire. That's what you get. I like the way this place looks. Without having any clue. If you're in a rural area and you hit that fast, yeah. You never really think about it. Like, I've gotten upset behind the wheel before and gone way too fast. Cruise control saves lives, man. You just, whoa. What was that? The Chase. Oh, that's the name of the show that I'm supposed to be participating in. See, yeah, if you get cruise control in your car, you can just set the speed and pay attention to what you're doing rather than how fast or how slow you have to be going at a time. It's really nice. It's probably in my old truck, which was an 85 truck. That shit didn't have cruise control and didn't have bunch of other stuff. Crank shit without knowing. Yeah, that's what I've. Whoa, why are you? Oh, this is a one-way road. Oh, that was an off-ramp. Okay, never mind. I was confused for a second. If your grandma is driving like that, she's probably like my grandma, who sometimes she'd go around curves that had trees blocking the entire thing, and she'd go around in the wrong lane because it was closer to the direction she was turning. My grandmother was an insane driver. That was nearly a good turn. I kind of fucked up there at the end, though. Holy hell, man. I'm moving in the hundreds of miles per hour, and I'm not getting there as fast as I thought it would. This scaled down United States is not as scaled down as I thought it was, at the very least. And that was actually decent. I liked that one. I stopped going the direction I wanted to go, and I didn't get hit by a train because I didn't even see the fucking train tracks. That was a dangerous concept. I saw the Golden Gate Bridge. Now I want to see the Space Needle. It's where I'm headed next. I ain't been to the Space Needle. I've seen it, but I ain't actually been there. I'm not headed to the Space Needle. I'm headed... Yeah, it was clean. I liked that. I was headed to the docks, just basically trying to get far distances. Where is... My waypoint is in the middle of this place. Am I in Seattle? I would have suspected that I'd have crossed through Portland at this point. I thought that that was a port city. I might be looking... Yeah, I mean, maybe. I don't know what I'm doing. I know for a fact that where I'm driving is not what I want to go and see. But it's close enough. I like these stadiums like this. Those stadiums are so nice. I hadn't really been in a real city in a while. Like, the largest place I've been in is a few hundred thousand people. And that's a small city, but it ain't a city like Seattle with, like, about a million. It ain't like Houston, going to Houston and Dallas. There's a lot of places I ain't been lately. You get stuck with a lot of the COVID shit. Can't go anywhere. But I don't have the kind of money, time, or anything to travel anyway. Oh, I got on a fucking overpass. You got a bunch of asterisks there. I'm gonna get off of this highway before I end up outside of the city. Maybe the Space Needle, I'm wondering, because it's always possible, that the Space Needle is actually, copywritten, and you can't put it in stuff. There's a lot of things like that. You can't put the Hollywood sign in things, because it's got a copyright or a trademark on the pictures of it, so you can't put it in everything. Maybe the Space Needle's the same thing. And I don't know where the Space Needle is in town either. Is that just a playground? Well, I'm in Seattle. Yeah, looks like they took the Space Needle out of this place. So I can't do nothing with that. All right, well, I got to see the Golden Gate Bridge, so that's something. Now I gotta figure out where next to go. It was a clip too sad moment. Cartography. I spent 5 minutes in the map. That's not a good thing. Spending a bunch of time in the map probably ain't good. I guess I should probably go to the Strip in Vegas. That's like halfway across the country here. Yeah, let's go to the Vegas Strip. I've spent at least a decent amount of time in my life just kind of driving around. Oh, the Division. Ubisoft really advertising their shit there. I've spent a decent amount of time in my life just kind of driving around, or not driving around, but riding around the United States. A lot of these places I've seen before. It's just been so many years since I've seen them that I kind of want to see them again. It's unfortunate that when I was a child and we were flying around all over the place, I didn't get to really pay attention to a lot of things. That guy drove right through me. It's kind of rude. Bam! Okay, that was... I'm glad there's not realistic car damage in this game. That was a head-on collision. I need to be more careful with that shit. Maybe not. I don't really have to care, then I might as well not care. 25 miles. I think it was like 9 miles from Los Angeles to Seattle. God, this trip is going to be a little bit longer than that trip was. I don't think I've actually been to Las Vegas. Opinion on your or on Chex Mix. I like Chex Mix when it's travel Chex Mix. I never liked it as a cereal. It's kind of an annoying cereal to me. Gets soggy too fast, got no flavor, nothing like that. But when I was traveling around a lot as a kid, we would buy the trail mix, and Chex Mix trail mix was a thing. It was too expensive, so we only got it when I was driving around with my grandparents. We couldn't afford it when it was just my... Okay, that was me. The shadow of me for some damn reason. Oh, that was mine. All right. Yeah, so my grandparents would buy that stuff, but my mom wouldn't. So it was all right when it was trail mix. But aside from that, I'm not really a fan. Oh, well, actually, when I got to be a teenager, there was, like, chocolate trail mix. That was cool for a little bit. It wasn't great forever. I only liked it for a little bit, and then I quit liking it. But it was all right when I had it. Same thing with, like, powdered sugar trail mix from Chex Mix. That stuff was all right, too. This feels more like my kind of backcountry. This feels more like the places I'm used to. Still hadn't hit a tree and died, so I guess I'm lucky on that one. Oh, this is the same spot that I came at earlier. That was an on-ramp. Grandparents back again with the spoiling. Yeah, my grandparents had money because my granddad... not rich. My granddad went gambling a lot, casinos in Louisiana. My grandmother was a teacher for many years, and when she retired, she had enough money to survive on, and he had enough money to survive on. Their retirement kind of worked in their advantage. Plus, they were both boomers, so they had a house that they didn't have to worry about. It was on family land. They built the house. Everything worked pretty well for them financially. So buying me and my brother good trail mix was probably one of the least of their money things. My mom did not have the money for that kind of thing, though. It was all low brand if we could get something. Though generally, we didn't get that stuff at all. Get like a bottle of soda at the store, and once a week we'd get a bottle of soda and some candy. That was pretty nice. Go to the Sit-Go, which I don't think is around anymore. I'm pretty sure they're not a company anymore. I tried using a car that wasn't an Audi or a Mazda or one of the nicer cars. I gotta unlock junk. I gotta actually spend some time and unlock things. I may do that at some point. I may not. I like this game. For the driving around, it's fairly nice. I like the scenery. But I don't know about sitting here and actually playing it too much. I'm just not a big enough fan of racing games, I don't guess. Racing modes usually feel like they're tacked on, and racing games don't usually have that much of a draw for me. Though this kind of road is pretty nice. I'm doing 130, and I'm not having almost any problems with turns or anything like that. I'm enjoying the fact that I can drive long distance extremely fast without hitting anything. The United States was built on roads. We did a whole lot without roads for a very long time. People were pioneers and did things on their own, completely separate from society. But then we started building roads and built roads everywhere. The only reason we have the infrastructure even the really big problem infrastructure that we've got today, because we decided we needed to build our entire country on the concept of highways. So the United States, more than a lot of other countries, is actually really great for driving through. Problem is, speed limits and stuff, even on these really long roads, keep you from having a scenic, nice drive. Ooh, now that's a cool view. I like that. Clouds covering the mountains. This would probably terrify the hell out of me if I was driving in real life. I don't like steep hills on the sides of roads. Drive a sports vehicle for that long. Well, been driving it for a while. It's the only car I've been driving. Probably ought to have gotten another car at some point. You guys are box trucks. You're not even 18-wheelers. Get the fuck out of my way. Don't make a convoy in the middle of the highway. Rude. Seen any of those barrels in the middle of the highway for a while. Feels kind of weird, actually. Usually see them every, I don't know, should see them at least once every little while. Man, y'all spamming me like crazy lately. Get a couple of you want to become famous things. Oh, damn it. Drive away from this area. Just get a fucking 1,000 yards away. I don't have a problem with that. I can get 1,000 yards away from this spot. Super easy. All right. It's becoming a big problem. I guess I got a bunch of things to report. Big old red circle trying to catch up with me. Trying to escape. Ooh. Nice. I got a few extra followers. For some damn reason, people cared about that. I hope I didn't miss another turn. Okay, good. That would have been very annoying if I had missed another turn there. It's kind of a weird thing, these spam bot accounts saying that, asking if you want to become famous. It's kind of pointless, ain't it? Becoming famous at your own expense, paying money to get fake viewers and followers and stuff like that. Like, what's the point? I thought the whole idea of getting people to watch your stuff was that people wanted to watch your stuff and you were excited that people actually cared to watch you. Spam like that doesn't really make a lot of sense to me. You want to do it as a career, you can get those and maybe you'll get real people to actually watch, but it's definitely going to cause you a problem later when people find out that a shitload of your views came from you buying them. It's like blackmail. Those kinds of people can say you went there and you bought the thing, we have your account. They can blackmail you with it, and you're just kind of stuck. I could cut right across the fucking desert here, but I think it's probably bad for my tires. I think it's also bad for my everything. Don't drive through the sand unless your vehicle's meant for it. This thing would get clogged up real bad. Kind of shocked at how close I am already. Just went through the damn trees. Kind of popped out into the desert from the trees. It was so sudden, I felt like it was like a lake rather than salt flats. We got scrub plains because all the water from the Hoover Dam comes down this way. They got a lake. I don't remember the name of the lake. Lake something. I didn't crash into a wall there. Yet more surprises. I'm not doing as bad as I thought I was going to. I should be using a controller. My controller didn't feel like working. Mouse and keyboard is really weird for driving stuff. I guess I got used to it at some point when I was a kid. Need for Speed on the computer, all we had was a keyboard, so it wasn't too bad. I almost hit that fucking light pole. At some point, I think I'm gonna have to, like, go and look through cars, get something that's a little more my style. Like an early 2000s or a 90s or an 80s vehicles, stuff that I'm a little more accustomed to. This thing's a little too new and a little too nice. I'm guessing that older stuff they probably wouldn't even put in this. The game probably doesn't include old vehicles, or at least nothing my speed or my style. Come and check out some stuff on the Las Vegas Strip. Everything off of the Las Vegas Strip, I've heard, is nice enough. It's actually a place people like to live. Well, that is kind of surprising to me. I don't know if I'd ever want to live in a place where there's this many tourists. Too many people just driving around. Alright, well, we got from Los Angeles to Seattle and down to Las Vegas. I guess the next place to go is Dallas? That's Santa Fe. Wait a minute, why is Santa Fe on here, but Albuquerque ain't? Albuquerque's the largest fucking city in New Mexico. That doesn't make any damn sense. Very weird to me. Well, I guess I'm going to fucking Dallas then. It's been a long time since I've been in Dallas. I think I won't recognize anything. Though I'm not too surprised that the city is covered in clouds. It always seems to be when I drive through there. Let's just do right there. This is going to be a bit of a long one. Vegas to Dallas is not going to be a short trip. I went from 9 miles to 25 miles to 43 miles. A long distance run here. Also, I'm pretty surprised that my stream stability is consistently good on this one. Like, for Minecraft, my stream stability is unhappy a lot of the time. It keeps telling me it's fine now. I wonder if the internet's just better today. Emerald. Time to drive off into the fucking mesas. These things are always kind of cool if you're driving out from a long distance. They look kind of cool. When you drive up close, they really just look more like, they look like any other environment, just kind of right next to things. Some roads have cool designs to them and stuff, but for the most part, the mesas are, oh, I hit a rock. The mesas are cool from a distance. That's what I'm trying to say. It seems kind of weird the amount of north I keep driving when I'm trying to go south. There's a lot of roads that kind of lean back north. I'm going east to west, or actually I'm going west to east, but driving west to east, I shouldn't be going so fucking north when I'm trying to head south. So even that's a sharp north. Road systems in the United States, pretty much everywhere, I'm guessing, but I know for a fact in the United States, are designed by, obviously, there's civic planners. The whole point of their job is to make a road go a place and all that, but they have to take into account a lot of things. Things that they take into account include rich neighborhoods and businesses. So what's good for drivers, what's good for traffic, is not always taken into account when they quite often take into account that there's a rich neighborhood nearby, the road has to go up towards that neighborhood, or there's businesses nearby, we gotta swing the road, the main road has to go over by that business center. Roads are planned out and designed to go in certain places and directions, and they're usually long roads are asking counties, like, where should we put this? And the counties just tell them where all the rich people's businesses are. It's another one of those systems that's kind of just designed. It's designed by the rich to help the rich. Roads are out in the middle of nowhere like this. There's not as much thought goes into them, but it's still the people with the most money are the ones telling you where they can and can't put stuff. Your ass fell asleep. You gotta get a nice chair. You gotta have something that you can sit down in and lean back. A recliner is a good thing to have. I'm always in a recliner. My back hurts less when I sit down in one. My ass doesn't go to sleep. Long drives like this, my ass always ends up feeling kind of funny. Especially with a wallet in my back pocket. I gotta take my wallet out for long drives. Car keeps fucking popping. I know that's like a thing you want it to do. That's a cool thing. I don't want it to do that. I want my car to sound like it's not dying every 10 seconds. This place looks kind of cool. I like the scenery here. Am I in Utah? It says Salt Lake there. I'm gonna cut into here. That is cool scenery. My ass has physically gone to sleep before. You fell asleep. See, that makes sense. But my ass has gone to sleep. I hadn't... I have no problem with falling asleep unless you're actually driving. That's probably not a good idea. But just going to sleep, it's a good thing. And being too comfortable leads to that, too. But I have had my ass actually fall asleep. So that's what I thought you meant. I know for a fact Steve ain't going to edit this shit down. He's just going to upload stream VOD to YouTube. So this whole thing, all the gaps in my speech and all the weird conversations, no context. It's all going up. I like this in I like this environment. This road is nice. Steve and Karina taking everything off for right now. Steve's just gonna take this, probably cut my long silences at the beginning and end, and then put it up. It's gonna take a long time to upload. Shit's gonna be a long video. I am planning on getting at least to all the coastlines. Hit California to Seattle, moving down to the Gulf Coast. I'm going to go from Dallas down to Houston, get to the Gulf of Mexico, and then I'll get over to Florida, and then maybe I'll head up to Maine. I don't think I've been to Maine since I was a baby, so I've never been there in my recollection. Oh, man. I'm going to say I did not hit that fox. Because there was no bump or nothing. I didn't feel anything. It didn't happen. The fox survived. Where am I? This place looks like it's populated. Well, it's not populated now. Never happened. What, Fox? Good. That's the kind of encouragement I need. People definitely following along with my story and my version of events. Road out here is real wet, but I've still got good grip, so I'm glad these tires don't suck as bad as mine usually do. Tires are expensive. New tires are expensive. Good tires are very expensive, even though they don't cost any more to produce than the other ones. It's the same material most of the time. It costs the same thing to produce, yet for some reason they cost a different amount of money to buy. Hero.
You do the off-road trial, you get a free vehicle to roam around. Cool, huh?
Yeah, sounds cool. I'm not doing that right now. I'm doing a cross-country drive in my Audi. Off-road would be nice, but I'm trying not to do a bunch of off-road shit at the moment. Trying to stick to actual roads, which is proving a lot easier than I thought it would be at the speeds that I'm driving. There's gotta be, there are. There's people who design powder into the tires so that when you burn out, they actually rip rubber away, and then the powder comes out in different colors. So there are burnout-specific tires, just extremely expensive. I'm not listening to you, Hero.
I'll keep talking anyway.
You're an asshole, Hero.
Do you remember that by doing events and stuff, you gain parts for customizing the look of your rides? And that you can equip them at the house? Heck, you can even purchase new ones if you want.
Dude, I don't give a shit. I don't care what you have to say. No shade to crawl. just drive for 93.2 miles. That's very specific. Some of these goals seem like somebody just tapped numbers into a keyboard and thought, all right, that's the number we're going to use. They didn't think about it. They didn't care. They just threw them up. I'm glad there's no cops in this game. Ah, damn it. Nobody cares about what this guy has to say. I'm sure there are some people do. I like games with a story. I like having a campaign mode, all that stuff. But I didn't buy this game for the campaign. Because there's no way I'm going to actually succeed in it. I'm not a good enough driver in these driving games to actually do a good race. Thought about doing all this in first person, sitting behind the wheel. But I feel like this is actually really difficult. Because I don't have as much peripheral vision as I do in real life. This shit is... I mean, it's bad. Nobody ever gives you the amount of actual peripheral vision you have in reality. And turning your head with the mouse, it just doesn't feel right. Because I can turn my head in real life and it takes no effort. And I can flip it back really quick. This just feels very, very dangerous. Very dangerous. My character is looking sort of off to the side now. And I don't see cars coming as easily. I am leaving that view before I get killed. What? Canyonlands Escape? Damn it. This fucking... Alright. I accidentally have entered so many fucking events. Some people open up the game and do that sort of thing. I got a friend who's really into this stuff. He's got like a VR rig that like has all the pedals and it's got a steering wheel and it shifts you around and shit, like it shakes you. That kind of thing. He enters into these kind of games and does the thing that they want you to do. But your average buyer isn't going to do that. Nobody who buys these games on sale is going to. Absolutely. Don't put things on the screen in front of me. That shit's dangerous. You're gonna make me crash, assholes. Feel like Hero just wants me to die. Throws shit up on my HUD. It's gonna get me killed one of these days. Though I guess if the game doesn't have car damage and I can't die, then I am technically an immortal being. Some sort. An elf or some sort of fae who's come here from, I don't know, long across the sea just to drive an Audi. Get a green Audi and drive it across the damn United States. There's other countries where the roads would be better. They're just not longer. We've got more roads than everybody else. We just don't have like the scenic beauty of all these other places. I bashed into a cliff. That was, it's very foggy. I think it's getting dark. This thing must have a day and night cycle on it. It looks like it's getting a bit dark out here. Central Woods, Roswell. I'm in New Mexico. Roswell 13 miles. Oh yeah, because the game is scaled differently. I was about to say, if I'm 13 miles from Roswell, I am not headed to Dallas right now. Those things are not close enough for that to actually make sense. Roswell is way down south. Ooh, damn. That looked... Oh, that's another sidewalk or road or something. I thought that was looking down into a canyon. Looks some dangerous shit right there. rock tire. I'm in the middle of nowhere, so they set up a racing camp in the middle of nowhere. This game ought to have fast travel. Driving across the country, finding events. I know that somebody who wants to actually play events probably doesn't want to drive across the entire country just to get to one. You probably want to actually, like, open up an event and play rather than drive for what is definitely like 20 or 30 minutes across the country just to get to some place that you were trying to play for like a quick game. Still just talking about Central Woods and Roswell. I still don't understand why Albuquerque isn't on this thing. It's bigger than Roswell. It's bigger than Santa Fe. I don't quite understand why they left it out. It would be like leaving out Flagstaff in Arizona just because there's... Or leaving out Phoenix just because there's Flagstaff. Doesn't really make any sense. All right. Well, hit a road sign. Been a while since I knocked one of those down. I'm going to head into Texas at some point. Actually, this looks a lot like when you're headed into Texas. Pizza Sonic? They changed the scenery around here real fucking quick. Drove to Santa Fe, and then I'm gonna get out of Santa Fe. That's not even the fastest way to get to Dallas from New Mexico. The fastest way to get to Dallas from New Mexico, if you're in Santa Fe, is to get onto I-25, go to I-40, and get on I-40 and go over to Dallas. Or I guess you'd have to get off of I-40 and get onto 257. Ow. I'm back in a part of the country that I actually recognize roads from, and they don't have the roads exactly right. Feel like somebody just made a bunch of roads throughout. They should at least have had all of the interstates. The interstates are like obvious clear roads that are very wide. It's a good idea to have roads that are really big in your driving game that's open world. Hello. How's it going, Muffin Man? I'm driving to places around the United States. Just kind of looking at places, and I'm headed to Dallas right now. It's going good. Well, I'm glad you're doing good. It's always nice. I am on PC. I'm having to drive with a mouse and keyboard because my controller didn't feel like working, and I don't have any of the setup. And that was stupid. I haven't crashed into one of those. Well, no, I've been crashing a lot more lately, so it's my fault. Amarillo. Headed to Amarillo. This looks like definitely not the right stuff. Play with you? I'm just touring the country. I'm not really going multiplayer. That, and I'm very bad at multiplayer because I'm an asshole. So, it's always something to be aware of. These trees do not look right for this part of Texas. They put redwoods in northern Texas? What the hell is wrong with the game designers? Is this Ubisoft Paris? Did they make this shit in France and think, well, nobody will notice that this is all wrong? get cash. Nah. I just started playing this game, and I don't give a shit about the cash or that follower system or any of those things. I don't really care about those. I appreciate the offer, though. I don't usually get offers to play games, though I have gotten a few offers from people who were like hacking the game and just wanted to make my day a little bit easier. It's a weird community, Twitch. Your mic quality is insane? What are you talking about? Is it bad? Or are you actually giving a compliment? That's always a little bit weird. It is very PogChamp. Dude, I'm way too old. That lingo makes no sense to me. I probably at some point ought to actually... Oh, yep, see, that was bad. I took some people's bikes out with me. I like having a good mic. I bought a good mic years ago so that I could do YouTube with it. I had a real shit mic, and then I got a good mic. And I like this one. But I was concerned because it's always possible with no air conditioner in this room that you're picking up all the bad sounds. I'm hoping that the mic quality stays this good if everybody's happy with it. Cool voice. See, now I like that. Cool voice. That's something... I don't hear that I'm cool, and I don't hear that my voice is cool. So I'm glad to have both of those happen. At least I'm going to interpret cool voice as I'm cool. I'm taking that from you. I am cool now. I don't care if it was just my voice. Now I'm taking that one too. Where the hell am I? I don't feel like this is the northern Texas I recognize. I feel like this is all made up northern Texas. Dallas 5, Amarillo 3? You are hip with the cool kids. Oh, well. I'm glad that the mic quality is good, and I'm glad that I'm now hip with the kids. I'll have to tell all my students that when I get back from summer vacation. Somebody on Twitch, the Muffin Man, told me I was cool. So y'all can all just deal with it, because I'm cool now. Some of this looks right. Some of it looks right, but some of this looks really, really wrong. Like, they got the wind turbines going. That's Dallas. That's Dallas right there. All right, at least I can see Dallas now. Getting closer. And that said 5 miles? But it was... That said 5 miles to Dallas, and then I'm right outside of Dallas. Also, they call it Dallas rather than the Dallas-Fort Worth metropolitan area. And I'm not entirely sure I'm actually driving into Dallas. I'm pretty sure I'm driving into Fort Worth. I need to get Big Bend. You're trying to redirect me to Big Bend? I'm way out of... That's insanity. They had to put up signs that direct you to places that are nowhere near where you're actually supposed to be going. They're trying to turn me around to Roswell, too. Like, get out of Texas and go back to Roswell. That's where you actually want to be. I don't mind New Mexico, but I ain't going back there from here. Seems a bit too far of a trip. Every time I say something about how I'm driving, I crash into shit. Doing perfectly fine until I comment on my driving or where I am, and then I crash into things. Take out somebody's electricity out here. They got some of this overgrowth, right? When you're driving into Dallas and Fort Worth, nobody cuts any of the grass, and they haven't for the last 50 years. They got some of those details perfect spot on. Love that. Some of this looks like California, though.
Oh,
I'm almost in to where I'm supposed to be, and then I'm headed down to Houston. There we go. I'm gonna park over here in the bicycle lane. Actually, I think that's probably the bus lane. You have Dallas, you better fucking have Houston. You bastards don't have Houston. What the hell is wrong with you? That's New Braunfels? You've got New Braunfels? You put the place with the fucking Schlitterbahn, but you didn't put Houston on here. What the hell is wrong with you? Galveston's probably too thin to have a road. Damn, man. And Texas is right next to Miami? Holy shit. You guys fucked up this entire side of the map. Oh, I feel very upset about that. Amarillo's like straight north of Dallas. They fucked this entire thing. This map is so wrong, it bothers me a lot. All right, well, I guess I'm going to New Orleans. Might as well head over that way. I'm going to have to head over here before I go to Miami anyway. I've never really been on a drive up the East Coast. And since that's where I'm headed after I get to Miami, I mean, it's close enough to doing it in reality. One of these days I'd like to take a train over that way. That way I don't have to drive myself. I do like driving. I just don't want to drive all that way, do all that when I could be taking a look at the scenery out a train window. See, that right there has got to be I-45. Or I-35. I missed my exit. Fucking shit. I got to get on the interstate, but there's no interstate in Dallas that just takes you to New Orleans. Oh, man. I feel so weird about all this, because this I have driven on before. I've been on this road. But it's supposed to take me down to Houston, which is a much more popular city, even if it's not more populated. It's a much more popular city for people to know in Texas. At least that was my assumption. I thought more people were aware of Houston than were aware of Dallas. Maybe Dallas is more famous. I didn't think it was. See, this feels like I'm driving on I-45 down south through like Centerville and shit. They got the biomes all weird in this country, and they got the fucking map all skewed. It's not like New Orleans is right next to Miami, but I feel like they just kind of erased Mississippi and Alabama. Not that many people would mind. If you erase Mississippi and Alabama, most of the country would probably be happier, but it's still not a good idea. They're neighbors. You're not supposed to erase their homes. I shouldn't be so mean about it either. These Ubisoft people probably aren't from the United States. I know that Ubisoft is based in France and Canada. I shouldn't be so upset that they don't know what Texas and Mississippi and Alabama look like. I should probably give them a break. I'm sure the people over in Jacksonville would be real upset that they're not there. I'm sure the people in Houston are kind of upset that they're not there. I'm sure Albuquerque's upset too. Any place that's got a couple hundred thousand people near a million or just over a million, you probably shouldn't just get rid of them altogether. In fact, I didn't see San Antonio down there, but I saw New Braunfels. That doesn't make any damn sense. New Braunfels is tiny compared to San Antonio. I think San Antonio is one of the biggest cities in Texas. Actually, I think San Antonio counts as one of the biggest cities in the United States. Huge Hispanic population that moved to that area where they can actually feel safe from all of the people in Texas who have a big problem with Hispanic people living in the state. Yeah, no state's really safe from discrimination, I guess. Feel like this is a lot shorter of a trip than it really should be. I've driven to New Orleans before, and from Central Texas, it's a long damn trip. You cannot tell. In fact, it's a longer trip than Santa Fe to Dallas. That seemed like it was a lot closer, though. It's kind of made the western part of the United States really big and broad and made the eastern part kind of squished up. Actually, that makes me think about it. Northeastern part of the United States is where most of the people in this country live, outside of the population corridor of Los Angeles to San Francisco. We got like San Diego and places like that. But I wonder if they erased a bunch of the fucking cities from there and get rid of Philadelphia and Pennsylvania and get rid of, actually, Pittsburgh up there too. Baltimore's probably there, Boston. I know New York's there. Having all those big cities and getting rid of all the other stuff, that seems kind of rude. And I put my map marker on the fucking highway, so have a good one, man. Enjoy. It's always nice to have a good 4th of July. Which is why I'm driving across the country. So I hope you have a good one doing that. Or, actually, doing whatever. Home? I don't want to go there. I want to go to Miami. But I don't want to go to, like, here. I think I'm just going to drive down to right there. That's fine. Then I got to figure out where the fuck to go from there. I'm on the highway, so that's not too much of a problem getting there. I was hoping to go to places like smaller towns. I should have suspected more highly that things weren't going to be right. I can see Miami from New Orleans. Whoa, asshole. Blinker, motherfucker. Should have turned his blinker on. Kind of guy get me killed. I guess I'm not shocked. I said I've driven out of Texas into Louisiana and into Mississippi and everything before. Driving over to Florida, people are more and more and more likely to get you killed the closer you get to Florida. I don't really know why. And I don't know why the traffic picked up. Actually, no, I know why. Because the roads suck so bad in Louisiana that traffic is constantly bad over there. It just fucked up the road so much that there's traffic all over this area. No traffic whatsoever when you're driving on like I-10 through Orange and all that shit. But when you get over past Louisiana, everything sucks and it's bumper to bumper all through the fucking freeway. I suspect this trip is going to be a lot shorter than a couple of the other ones have been. Because I'm not... Actually, no, that thing says it's a little bit longer. I guess they've made some of the cities much bigger. So you've got, like, more time in the cities. And then just, like, warped the map around those. Dallas wasn't all that big. But they made Miami fucking huge. And I suspect they did the same thing with New York City. Suspect they probably did the same thing with Los Angeles. San Francisco didn't seem all that big, and neither did Seattle. just on the map. Billboards down here for the agency. That's just not how billboards down there work. Billboards down there are all about abortion and Jesus. That's it. And porn shops. It's just anti-abortion signs, signs that say you should find Jesus, and then signs that say there's a porn shop up ahead. Those are the only billboards in Florida. Or actually, in fact, seemed like the only billboards I ever saw in Florida or Alabama. So, I guess it's probably both of them. They erased Alabama altogether, though, so definitely in Florida right now. I left New Orleans and was in Florida. I'm sure a lot of people be real happy with that. I'd be real happy with that. It'd make going to, like, Universal Studios or Disney, it'd make going there a lot fucking faster. If I could just skip over Mississippi and Alabama. Hey, visited Cape Canaveral. That's not where Cape Canaveral is. You guys put that in the wrong fucking spot. But I don't care. Yet more, I'm just kind of driving across the country. I didn't really particularly mind all the things being skewed off in weird ways. Yeah, actually, Miami's here, but Orlando's not. Okay, I hit that man into a car. He should be dead. But so should I, and so should the driver of that car, so I guess it ain't too big of a problem. I wasn't gonna just intentionally hit people, but I did need to make a right-hand turn. So, guy was in my way, and it's entirely his fault for being in my way. Oh, look at that. A parking lot. First time I found a parking lot while I was trying to switch over to something else. Oh, look at this asshole. Parked in multiple spots. And your car is way too big. Physically larger vehicles than they should have. That van is smaller than it ought to be, and these sedans are much larger than they ought to be. I guess that's why they're not real. They just put in models. That's disappointing. You should do a better job with your games. All right, they got a big Chicago area. They got a big Detroit area. They got big New York. Got no Boston? This is Massachusetts right here. Yeah, Cape Cod? But no Boston. What is wrong with you people? I mean, I guess I'm gonna go up to Niagara Falls. That's a place that makes sense for me to go. Go here. Get up to the actual falls. That's a place I hadn't been in. I don't know if I've ever actually been to Niagara Falls. I know I hadn't driven there as an adult. I don't remember if I was ever taken there as a kid or not. When you got family that likes to travel, sometimes you get dragged along with them. Sometimes it's great, sometimes it ain't. Casinos in Louisiana have kids areas because there's so many people who take their kids over to casinos. I'm sure that's what all casinos are like, actually. Went to a place called Laughlin, Nevada when I was a kid. That place had kids' areas all over the place. It was definitely a casino town.
Hallelujah.
I must say, I am disappointed. But I've already said that, so I guess it's pretty obvious. But I was expecting more out of this than, what I got. And that's not their fault, that's mine. They never said it was a perfect one-to-one representation. They said it was a scaled-down version, but I'm starting to think that that was part of other people's rhetoric, and I don't know if that was actually Ubisoft claiming that it was part of theirs. You can drive across the United States, but it's not really a scaled-down United States. It's a warped United States, like some sort of weird upside-down version of the place. Just accentuate all the really big areas. Leave all the places nobody talks about out of it. I wonder about that. Maybe they asked somebody in Ubisoft Paris. Maybe they asked somebody over there to draw a map of, like, the United States, where all the states are and all that. And they actually put Louisiana right next to Florida. They put Louisiana right next to Texas. They didn't know where to put Mississippi and Alabama. They didn't know where to put Tennessee or Kentucky or any of those. They didn't know what the hell they were doing with a bunch of places. So they just made all those really big. And I don't quite get why I'm driving through small towns like this, when you could have done this for even the bigger places. Chattanooga? They put Chattanooga in this place, but not Houston. I feel very, very annoyed at that sort of thing. I'm getting that vibe from fucking every place, though. Just drive by a sign and see one that says a place that definitely should not be in the game compared to a much, much larger place. Get me on a fucking freeway. I need to stop seeing all these small towns. They're horrible. I wonder if there's trains in this game. There's actually trains running everywhere. Maybe I just hadn't seen them yet, but they exist. Maybe they don't exist, and I haven't seen them because they're not there. Can't be too surprised by something like that. Also, I'm pretty damn sure no map, no GPS in its right mind would take you into New York City to get to Niagara Falls from Miami. No GPS in its right mind would do that unless you tell it you're flying to New York City, in which case it didn't take you there, you decided you were going there. That ain't your technology's fault. You gotta take some responsibility, I guess. I'm absolutely gonna have to drive through New York City, though. I don't think I can avoid it. Fucking massive. They just decided that Los Angeles, Miami, and New York City were all the only things the United States ever has to offer, without thinking about the fact that it is one of the largest countries on the planet, filled with a bunch of empty space that would be good for driving through. I would love to be able to get every car I see on the road in this game. All of these cars would be fucking great. If I could just, like, get the cars and drive around in, like a big old Ford van. Those vans are massive. Getting those things and driving around the country would be kind of cool. Though it would take a lot longer than this Audi's taking. Audi would definitely never sponsor me. Not just because of how incredibly unlikely it is anyone will ever do that, but also, I've crashed their car so many times, I highly doubt they would find it a good idea to give this guy money. Giving me money be a terrible idea when I keep crashing your fucking car. I think they mixed a couple places together in here. Get the distinct impression that this does not look like the outskirts of New York City. Though I'm certainly driving like one of them. I know that driving in New York City is a dangerous thing. Oh, and they got a thing over here on the... Is that the Washington Bridge? I don't know the names of the bridges in New York City. The Brooklyn Bridge. Washington Tunnel, isn't it? Still about 19 miles outside of Niagara Falls. Oh, you dick. I think that guy actually did have his fucking blinker on. I just can't see it with how far away I am from their blinkers. If I really concentrate, I can weave through traffic no problem. But that's not too incredibly fun. I have to pay attention to this. I also got to think about a few other things right now. For one thing, it's way too damn hot in here. And my stream stability finally had like a little glitch. It hadn't had one up to this point, but it finally had one. Where it was like, hey, we're pushing a little hard here. You are running a quite long video on this. You're trying to run it at 1080. And you're trying to run it like 1:1 rather than having a delay. That's a dangerous thing to try and do on a hot day when your computer could probably cook an egg. I need better cooling systems in my computer. Tell you, I know that much. Oh! Oncoming traffic. I am not great at that. Deploy? Why does it say that? At some point, I ought to go back and play through some more of the game so that I can understand, like, why is it telling me this thing? Why does it say do this? Alright, this one is one of those nice bridges. I'm gonna guess it's one of the famous ones. I don't know the bridges in New York very well. I don't know the bridges in New York at all, really. I've barely ever been to New York. I went to upstate New York. I've never been to New York City. So I'm trying to drive through all this and get to upstate New York where there's actually something interesting to see. Go to Niagara Falls. State New York than I remember. Pretty damn sure this place was just completely fucking like empty every time I've been up that way. I wonder what they did to the north part of the country, like Montana, Wisconsin. All those places have got to be shrunk down too. As a teacher of geography, this makes me more upset than it probably should. but seeing the country all warped and weird is definitely upsetting for me. Finally, the road emptied out a bit. Get this fucking traffic out of here. There are not this many people driving around on these roads. This seems like one of those games. If I'd had it when I was a kid, my brother and I probably would have driven everywhere across this whole country, picked up every single little thing that we could. We'd have spent days playing a game like this. I wouldn't be too surprised if that's something that a lot of kids have probably done with this game. Sit down and play it for a couple days, just getting all the shit unlocked. I would definitely love this game in VR. I'd love to have like the whole driving setup and all that stuff, hook it up with VR and everything. That'd be great. God, what is with all the traffic up here? Why do they think upstate New York is just fucking packed? There's nobody living in upstate New York. It's the country. You live out in the middle of nowhere, so you don't... I think I just killed myself on that deer. I absolutely hit that motherfucker. They should have ragdoll physics for everybody. People and animals in this game should have ragdoll physics. If you're gonna have nature, I ought to be able to hit it and throw it up over the top of my car. And if you're gonna have cities, I ought to be able to hit people and throw them up over the top of my car.
I know. You do what you want in the order that you want.
You've said this specific thing to me before.
You need an off-road trial, you get a free vehicle to roam around. Cool, huh?
Yeah, kind of cool, but I don't really need an off-road vehicle right now, bud. Hero, you're kind of interjecting yourself, and I don't really care. All right, I do a bit of off-road. That doesn't mean I need you, Hero. Most of my off-road is on accident. There's such nice houses and nice scenery and all that stuff up here. And then a giant radio tower. I hadn't had those anywhere else. I hadn't seen light poles, or I hadn't seen electric poles pretty much anywhere. Though I see street light lamps, and that's just not how that works. Most highways do not have street lamps. Somebody just decided that the code, I bet they didn't put each one of those in individually. They probably coded the game so that highways and roads would have street lamps on them. And then they put street lamps on fucking every road, and that is not how that's supposed to work. The U.S. doesn't have street lamps on pretty much any roads. Am I coming into fucking Niagara Falls from the north? Hey, Niagara Falls. Said I'm sightseeing, but I'm driving to the falls right now. It gave that thing to me way before I got there. I see the river over there. I kind of want to jump the car off the falls. Think I'm going to do that. If I can get over to Niagara Falls, then I'm going to throw my car off of it. Well, those are just some regular falls. Those aren't Niagara Falls. I guess they are. Or I guess they're supposed to be. Well, that's kind of disappointing. I was hoping it'd be a lot taller. Niagara Falls is definitely a lot taller than that. Yeah, Las Vegas is really high up north. I find that really weird. They made Vegas really high up north for some reason. Yeah, I don't think there's anywhere else for me to go on here. I drove up the West Coast, drove down to Miami, drove up the East Coast. The West Coast is fucking tiny because they decided to make Miami huge. They didn't even make Los Angeles all that big. Mostly filled with streets, but it ain't all that big compared to Miami, which is fucking massive, and New York, which is also way larger than it ought to be. Well, I think I'm probably done then. They call this Washington rather than Washington, D.C. Good God. Actually, you know what? I'm not done. I am going to go to Washington, D.C. I'm going to go right here. It does make sense for me. I've always wanted to visit D.C. I've never gone there before. At some point, I plan on doing it. I think history teachers and, I guess, teachers in general probably ought to visit Washington, D.C. at some point. Maybe one day, whatever school I work at will actually take me on a field trip. Let me go as a chaperone on a field trip with students.
Check out the freestyle trot.
You should shut the fuck up, hero.
A freaking plane. Think about how fast you can go coast to coast with that. Never mind getting creative with all the crazy stunts you'll be able to do.
Hero, you're starting to upset me. I hope I don't have to drive back through all that weird-ass upstate New York traffic just to get to Washington, D.C., which, by the way, is not that far into the fucking country. All right, that was definitely death. I hit that tree going way fast, way, way faster than I ought to. I feel like it's probably a good idea for people to visit their nation's capital. Not necessarily to see, like, where wonderful things or where terrible things happen, depending on your point of view of politics. But people should visit their nation's capital. You should know what the capital looks like. You should not do it in some sort of weird insurrection. That would be a stupid thing to do. But you should visit the Capitol. I still haven't. I don't know if I've ever been to the Capitol. I think that Washington, D.C. might be one of those places that... I think Washington, D.C. might be one of those places that we never went when I was a kid. That was an elk. All right. I'm glad I didn't hit that with my car. They didn't even call it D.C. The District of Columbia, Washington, is very different from the state of Washington. They're not the same place. Washington State is... I already visited Washington State. It's over with Seattle. It's upsetting that somebody designed the map so poorly. But at least they put the nation's capital in. And I can't complain about the nation's capital all that much because I ain't ever been there before. I couldn't tell you what the layout of the city is. I couldn't tell you how wrong they are. I only ever been there in Flight Simulator, so... I mean, that's enough for me to know what some of the place looks like, but... I can't complain about it at the very least. You know, I'd love it if there was a cruise control in this game. Set your speed to like 60. Put it at like 65, like the nation's speed limit of 50 or 55, something like that. And just let it drive while you steer. It would probably feel like one of the slowest driving games ever. But it would be kind of cool. That is the biggest fucking on-ramp loop I've ever seen. Good God. It's like a mile in its own right. Considering they scaled everything up a lot, I'd say that probably, that is a huge fucking loop. Like a big truck that I could drive around in and knock down trees. If I could knock down all the trees, could just drive straight across the country. I think that'd probably make this game too easy, though, because then you could just do all the races with a truck that could knock buildings down. I think I've died multiple times in this little trip of mine. I'm very glad that I'm not playing GTA or something that has car damage. I would be fucked up. Like a video game idea where you can do absolutely anything. It's like the dream video game. It's what the Oasis is in Ready Player One. It's actually, I bet it's that, like, that Ryan Reynolds movie. I don't remember what it's called. Extra Man or something like that. That concept seems like a game like this, but if you use like the Google Maps API to design the road system, and then used Google Earth to design the scenery on the sides of the road and that sort of thing. Then used, let's say, like a real professional made racing game that's like a track racing game, so not open world, but has like the full physics of every car, like Forza. You mix in those things, then you'd have a really cool just racing game. then the ability to get out of your car and buy a house and farm the land and all of that stuff. You can do whatever you want to, and then the ability to, like, open up portals to a hell dimension, like in Minecraft, and then you could go and fight monsters and get ores and upgrade your tools and become an RPG. All of that would be too big of a game. This is what Star Citizen is. Like, the idea of having an entire massive universe, like No Man's Sky, a giant universe, and then adding in all of these other features, like building and buying your own ship and flying it wherever you want and customizing the thing and all those things. That stuff is really cool, but it takes, as Star Citizen knows, it's taking way too long. It's taken them more than a decade, and they hadn't finished a fucking game yet. So you gotta design it with new systems and new things. You gotta update the graphics. You gotta get everything going faster. Like, well, there's new technology that'll let this move faster and all those things. We designed it with an engine that's old, so we gotta update everything. And that means redesigning everything in a new engine. A game like that would be fucking amazing. It probably would be one of those, like, the last game you ever buy kind of things. Because I've played Minecraft for about 12 years now. And I keep going back to it. Finally here. I think. Is this? Yeah, this is DC. I'm less than a mile away. They made DC pretty big. Not a lot of cars that are actually driving around in here. And there's the White House. I want to actually see the White House. Here it is. It's a lot smaller than it ought to be. Scale down the buildings too, I guess. It does mean I can get to the Washington Monument. I can see it. There's a reflecting pool. And then the Lincoln Memorial. That's what it's supposed to be anyway. Doing a bit of off-roading. What? Alright, I don't know the Capitol very well, but if you're going to have the Washington Monument, you probably ought to have the Lincoln Memorial, too. There's the... Is that the Jefferson Building? There's all these people sitting down in the park. I'm driving here. Y'all are just gonna have to stop doing your Tai Chi and shit. Quit having your picnics. Oh, that's the Capitol Building. That's the Capitol Building. All right, well, Assassin's Creed symbol. I didn't even see the Assassin's Creed symbol. Did they make it out of the roads here or something? Maybe I missed it entirely. Yeah, that looks like the Assassin's Creed symbol made out of pathways. Well, I think I've gone everywhere I really felt like going. I got all around the country a lot faster than I ever will in my real life. And I hit a lot more people and animals than I probably ought to have. My car is now kind of fucked up because I won't stop off-roading in an Audi. So I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you come back for the next one. I'll see y'all later. Bye.